Talk to the Lord, all you lands. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with singing. Know that the Lord is God. It is he who has made us, and not we ourselves. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. Enter into his gates with thanksgiving and into his courts with praise. Bless his name, for the Lord is good. His mercy is everlasting, and his truth endures to all generations. What a great joy to invite you all. What a blessing to sing to the glory of our God this wonderful hymn in this beautiful earth that God has allowed us to live in excellent health with loved ones on this wonderful Thanksgiving morning. May we stand to sing for the beauty of the earth. For the beauty of the earth, for the glory of the skies, for the love which from above over and around us lies, Lord of all, to thee we lean. This our hymn of grateful praise for the wonder of each hour, of the day and of the night. Hill and vale and tree and flower, sun and moon and stars of Lord of all, to thee we reign. This our hymn of grateful praise, for the joy of human love, brother, sister, parent, child, friends on earth, her pure sacrifice. Lord of all, to thee we raise this full praise, for the church that evermore lifteth holy hands offering upon every shore her pure sacrifice of love. Lord of all, to thee we reign, this a hymn of grateful praise, for the joy of hearing, for the heart and mind's delight. Mystic harmony, linking sense to sound and sight. Lord of all, to thee we reign, this our hymn of grateful praise, for thyself best give one to our race so freely give, for that great, great love of thine, peace on earth and joy in hell. Lord of this a hymn of go to the throne of grace. Glorious Father of Abraham, Isaac, and Israel, we have come, Lord, into your presence with the love for you, with joy in you, and Lord God, with gratitude, with thanksgiving in our hearts. Lord, you have done it all well. Lord, you have kept us as the apple of your eyes since the beginning of this year. We went out, we came back safe, a given food to eat, clothes to wear, shelter to have, loved ones to cherish. Lord, you have given meaning and purpose to our life. In our toil, we experience your grace. Lord God, we thank you with all our heart for the greatest gift of all, the free gift of salvation. Our names written in the book of life, your Son's love, that is an everlasting love for each and every one of us. Lord God, we thank thee for giving us the word of God, through which you speak to us so tenderly, with love, with such counsel, such depth, Lord, we are unable to fathom. Thank you, Lord, for the miraculous, mysterious way you keep us in the center of thy will. We wander, Lord, far from your ways, but you bring us back to your ways. Lord, we have tendencies to forget you and even forget the blessings and take them for granted. But somehow, your spirit is always loving and kind and patient and persevering us, bringing us back to your feet. Lord, what a loving God you are, always forgiving, always embracing us, always, Lord, ready to give counsel. Lord, we thank thee. You are the source of all that is good, yet the source of all that is best in life. Lord, we thank thee for the breath in our nostrils, for the health that we could enjoy. Thank you for giving us a family church. Lord, we did not have a building. We struggled. But in all our struggle, you gave us faith. You gave us promise. You gave us hope. We thank thee, Lord, for this sanctuary of yours. 2 years ago, Lord, you gave us, and you have blessed us beyond measure. Lord, it's a mystery, it's a miracle, what great things you have done to this little church in India and in Kenya, various mission work. Lord God, we thank thee. Only you could do it. We thank thee, Lord, for this blessed country of USA. Lord, you brought us. We did not know each other, but you brought us together as a family in this blessed country. We thank thee, Lord. Thank thee for this wonderful place that we could call it our home. Thank thee for many, many blessings you have given to us in this blessed country. We pray, Lord, that will bless our president, our vice president, congressmen, senators. We pray, Lord, your blessings to be upon our governors and judges. We thank thee, Lord, you will guide them with your wisdom so that, Lord, this country will be a beacon of light, a city set on a hill. Lord God, we pray for our mother country, India, that thou will bless our mother country from where we all came. Lord God, we pray thou will keep the doors open for good news to be given to people. We thank thee, Lord, for the miraculous, mysterious way you sustain pastors and evangelists across the globe, the new Christians and many, many poor Christians. Lord, you give them meaning and purpose. We thank thee, Lord, you speak to us through thy word. We pray, Lord, thou will continue to be with those persecuted Christians, those who translate the word of God. We pray for your presence to be with thy children across the globe, especially in war-torn areas like Ukraine, Lord, other places, disturbed places like Iran and other places. We lift them up into your presence. We pray for blessings upon the peoples of this world. Lord, we thank thee for the compassion you have given to us to be merciful to others. Lord, we thank thee for every blessing. We are unable to count them. They are more in number than the sand. Lord, you have taken care of us in the time we were conceived in mother's womb all the way to this very moment. You made blessing out of our lives. Lord, we are nothing. Let the beauty of Christ, more than anything else, be upon us. Wash us, cleanse us in thy blood. More than anything, Lord God, give us a heart of gratitude, a heart filled with thanksgiving. Let the word of the Lord go forth so that we will find a fine, eternal lodging place in our hearts. Anoint our singing. Bless and receive our witnesses. We pray, Lord, in all this, you be exalted. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Please be seated. What a great joy to welcome you all into God's presence this beautiful morning. It's a great joy to be here. We welcome all of you. Praise team members can come. Welcome all of you into God's presence. And those who are visiting, we want you to know that what a joy to have you visit with.
Good morning. Happy Thanksgiving to everyone who's come here this morning. It's a time of reflection. It's a time of giving thanks to God. As a family, to come together as ICC family, to think of all what God has done for us. It's going to be a time of casual worship. So I want Kamna, you can join us. And Viola, you can join. Just join us. Yeah. Amen. Praise you, Jesus. Hallelujah. I was just thinking that we could sit and reflect and worship the Lord. Can we all sit down for a moment, please? Thank you.
For today, for this gift of breath and life, we give you thanks. For this church, this community gathered here to worship, we give you thanks. For your creation, the changing seasons, falling leaves, we give you thanks. For your mercy, for your forgiveness, for your love, we give you thanks. In our weakness, we thank you, for your power is made evident. In our failures, we thank you, for your grace is sufficient. Even in the trials, through the struggles and pain, as you form us into who you want us to be, turning our mess into your message. Today and every day, we give you thanks.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul. Worship His holy name. Sing like never before, oh my soul. I'll worship Your holy name. Bless the Lord. Worship His holy name. Sing like never before, oh my soul. I'll worship Your holy name. The sun comes down, it's a new day gone. It's time to sing Your song again. Forever may pass, and whatever lies before me, let me be singing as the evening comes. Bless the Lord, bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my worship His holy name. Sing like never before, oh my soul, I'll worship Your holy name. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul, worship His holy name. Sing like never before, oh my soul, I worship Your holy name. And on that day when my sing like never before, oh my soul, I worship Your holy name. Bless the Lord, bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul, worship His holy name. Sing like Your holy name, Lord, I worship Your holy name.
I'm sure there have been moments when we've all been beneficiaries of our friends or our family or a stranger, an angel that has helped us in different ways. Or maybe we've helped people in different ways. Whether small or big, sometimes it's the timing that matters, not the size of how big that help was. And those are moments that sometimes we don't have words enough to describe how to thank them. And all we can say is just thank you so much and thank you so much. And just keep on repeating thank you so much. And that feeling that we get during those moments, I think is just so awesome that there's no words to describe that. But who is more worthy in our lives than our loving Heavenly Father, who has done so much for us? Like every moment of our lives, every day of our lives, from the time we were conceived in our mother's womb, He has blessed us and kept us and saved us and loved us and just showered His magnanimity on us. Psalm 23 says, "Your goodness and mercy will follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever." It's a promise that God made to us that His goodness and His mercy will follow us. But we make a promise back to Him that we will dwell in His house forever. As we sing this song, "You have been so good to me," I want us all to take a moment to reflect. I know we do this a lot and every day, but today is one of the best days that we can specifically think about everything that our loving God has done for us from the time we were born. Maybe there's one moment, maybe there's many moments. Maybe that moment of your first love and how He has drawn you back to Him and how He has led you since then. Please think about that as we sing this song.
You have been so good to me.
Shall we all stand up and sing?
You have been so good to me. I came here broken. You made me whole. You have been so good. You have been so good. You have been so good to me. You have been so good to me. You have been so good to me. I came your morning. You gave me joy. You have been so good. You have been so good. You have been so good. How can I thank you? There is just no way. How can I thank you? Lord, how can I repay for your kindness, for your tenderness, for your constant presence here with me? You have been so good to me. So good to me. I came your broken. You made me whole. You have been so good. You have been so good. You have been so good to me.
You have been so good.
You have been so good. You have been so good to me.
Yes, Lord, you've been so good to me. You've been so good to all of us, Lord. God has blessed us and preserved us through highs and lows, through ups and downs. I'm sure all of us can testify that his goodness has followed us throughout our lives. But he has also handheld us when we did not know him. And my own life is a testimony of that. Once we know his love, we can't stop singing of his goodness. With our every breath, let us give glory to our God, our Lord. With our every breath, let's say, I love you, Lord. I love you, Lord.
I love you, Lord, for your mercy never fails me, and all my days I've been held in your hands. For the moment that I wake, till I lay my head, I will sing of the goodness of God. And all my life you have been faithful. And all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I will sing of the goodness of God. I love your voice. You have led me through the fire. In darkest night, you are close like no other. I've known you as a father. I've known you as a friend. The goodness of God. And all my life you have been faithful. And all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness Your goodness is running out. It's running out to me. Your goodness is running out. It's running out to me. With my life laid down and surrendered now, I give you everything. Your goodness is running out. It's running out to me. Your goodness is running out. Yes, it's running out to me. Your goodness is running out. It's running out to me. Put my life laid down and surrendered now. I'll give you everything. Your goodness is running out. It's running out.
Isn't that our testimony? All our life, God has been faithful. I'm standing here, it's because of His faithfulness. Can you just sing that chorus one last time together? And all my life,
You have been faithful.
From all your heart, from deep within.
All my life You have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness of God.
And all my life.
Every breath that I am able, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. I will sing of the goodness of God.
It's only with gratitude that life becomes rich. A sensible thanksgiving for mercies received is a mighty prayer in the Spirit of God. It prevails with Him unspeakably. This is what John Bunyan said. In happy moments, I praise God. Yes. In difficult moments, I seek God. Yes. In quiet moments, I worship God. In painful moments, I trust God. But every moment, I thank God. This is what Rick Warren said. Every moment I thank God because He's been good to me. I think without the service here this morning, our thanksgiving wouldn't be complete. Every dinner, every fellowship, everything, without coming and giving thanks to God as ICC Church, God has been good to us. He's met all our needs. Every desire of our heart is fulfilled, right? Won't you just lift your hands and your hearts and just worship Him? Oh Lord my God, when I in awesome wonder consider all the worlds Thy hand hath made, I see the stars, I hear the saves my soul, my Savior God, through Thee. How great Thou art, how great Thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to Thee.
Sings my soul. sings my song, my Savior died to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul,
give a clap offering to the King of Kings, the one who means everything to us. Hallelujah.
Let's pray. Father, we thank you, Lord, for the privilege you have given us to gather here and worship you, Father. With so much thankfulness, we have gathered here, Lord. Thanks for being with us, Father. Thanks for guiding us as a good shepherd, Lord, good teacher. Thanks for being with us as a shield, Father, Lord. Thanks for being our wonderful counselor, Prince of Peace, Everlasting Father. We love you because you first loved us, Father, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Lord, thanks for providing us, Father, Lord. Thanks for delivering us from so many problems, Lord. Thanks for being with us always, Father, Lord. Thanks. You are a victorious God, Father. You are an all-powerful God. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, continue to be with us, Father, Lord. Be with our pastor as he gives the message, Father, Lord. Speak through him, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
We are thankful to God for this wonderful Thanksgiving morning and for the wonderful testimonies came from the hearts of people. And I know that there were others who wanted to give. I don't know, we have enough time at the Watch Night service that comes on 31st of December. Once again, we welcome all those who have chosen to worship with us. May the Lord bless you. And it's amazing to see how hearts are filled with gratitude for all the blessings God has given. After World War II, two families were waiting in line after the worship service and to greet the pastor. And the church was at that time having some building extension. So the first family in line said, "Pastor, as you know, our son was killed in the World War II. We would like to give $200 as a memorial gift." So the pastor was moved and he received the gift. Then a second family stood in the line and they said, "Pastor, we are going to give $200, but our son came home. But we have decided to give $500 as a result of that." Imagine gratitude flows from the heart, be it a loss of a son in the war or a return of a son safe from the war. God has given us all reasons to be grateful and thankful to God for. In the 1800s, you would have heard about a person called George Mueller. If not, you can give that small books or something like that to your children to see what a mighty man of faith he was, a prayer. He ran a big orphanage in Bristol, England. I've always been inspired by George Mueller. And this man determined in his heart that he will never put out his hand to any human being. He was totally convinced that if God could feed the millions of people in the wilderness with manna and meat and water and everything, that same God is his God. And he had over 1,000 orphans in his orphanage in Bristol, England. It's even going on. George Mueller, you go and search in the Google about this wonderful man God chose and used him. He had a rough, challenging youth, but he gave his life to Christ and the life got transformed. Little that he knew that he would be called a missionary of gigantic faith. So, one morning there was no food to eat, but he called all the children and the staff of the orphanage, and he prayed and thanked God for the provision of food, even though no food was on the table. Children were seated for food, no food. Right after he finished thanking God and said amen, and the children said amen, there was a baker who knocked on the door. He said, "Mr. Mueller, God had led me to give all these bread, loaves of bread to you, and would you please have it?" And he delivered it, and he left. Then there was, after a few moments, a milkman knocked at the door, and he said the milk truck had broken down, and would you please have all the milk for the orphanage? Imagine that God is your God and not my God, isn't it? We will lack nothing, you know. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall lack nothing, isn't it? Can anybody say I lack something? No, we cannot lack anything. We have come here to say, Lord, you have kept me food to eat, clothes to wear, shelter to have, loved ones to cherish. You have given me free salvation. What else we need from God? Breath in our nostrils and health. Amazing God, isn't it? What a great God we have. And today, we've got to focus quickly on Thanksgiving, a Christian distinction. Someone said, gratitude is an offering precious in the sight of God, and it's one that the poorest of us can make, and be not poorer, but richer for having made that thanksgiving. A visiting farmer stopped at a city restaurant to have his lunch, and when the food was brought to him, he bowed down. That was his custom of saying thanks to God. And some teenagers, bubbling with energy and, of course, with the sitting nearby table, noticed the farmer praying and shouted at him, "Hey, Pops, back where you come from, does everybody pray before they eat?" "Of course." The laughter was quietly silenced when the shrewd and unmoved farmer answered, "Nope, the hogs don't." And the teenagers got the lesson. Here, in this church, have you noticed at SLM, who would pray? All the little kiddos are lining up ready to pray before meal, isn't it? And I'm proud to be the pastor of this church. SLM is a vision given by God, and it's unique in our church. Very interesting how our children can say thank you to God, and the food is blessed. During all this virus season, we had food. No, nobody died of food. Nobody died of virus. They had stood strong in spite of it. Helen Keller, you know, some of you know that. If not, teach your children. Go through the Google and talk about Helen Keller. As she said, "So much has been given to me that I have no time to ponder that which I don't have." She became blind when as an infant due to some screw-ups, mistakes done by ophthalmologist, eye surgeon. What great Helen Keller. It's amazing, you know. W.W. Westermeyer said the pilgrims made 7 times more graves than huts. Nevertheless, they set aside a day of thanksgiving. So, if you read this, Ephesians 5:18 says very clearly, let's turn to Ephesians 5:18. Ephesians Ephesians 5:18 says, "And do not be drunk with wine, in which is dissipation, but be filled with the Spirit, Holy Spirit, speaking to one another in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing and making melody in your heart to the Lord, giving thanks always for all things to God the Father, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ." What a glorious words are these for us this morning. Giving thanks for all things to God the Father. Giving thanks for all things. For all things should mean in your context and my context, many answers came as no from God. Many answers God is telling, wait. And many, a few answers that God at this time for his glory said yes. The evidence of this Holy Spirit filling, that is, be filled with the Holy Spirit, says that, right? Three things gives in these three verses. One is it. What is that evidence? Joyful always, no matter what. Thankful, verse 20. And also it says, verse 21, submitting to one another in the fear of God. Three things will be very evident if you have the fullness of the Holy Spirit. Carefully see that. Fullness of the Holy Spirit, joyful, thankful, and submissive. Now, let's go to Colossians chapter 3 that you heard. Colossians chapter 3, and then verses 16 through 25. And then it goes on to say, we are instructed to be filled with the Word of God, isn't it? We are told to have the Word of God, let the Word of God dwell in us richly. We are instructed there, let the Word of God dwell in you richly in all wisdom, teaching and admonishing one another, etc. So, first thing is proof of being filled with the Holy Spirit. Of course, love, John, 1 Corinthians 13. But again, being proof of being filled with the Word of God, we will be joyful, read that, Colossians 3:16, and thankful, Colossians 3:17, and also submissive, verses 20 all the way to 25. Isn't it? Three evidences of, these are very similar to running, proof of Holy Spirit and proof of being filled with the Word of God. These three spiritual characteristics of the believer are controlled by God's Spirit and God's Word, and they always go together. This theme is presented in Psalm 100, isn't it? Be thankful. You know, Psalm 100 is a beautiful psalm that carefully says, we have to put together Word of God with the Word of God. That's a way to understand better interpretation. Verse 4, enter into his gates with thanksgiving, Psalm 100. And it is quotes with praise. Be thankful. Be thankful to him and bless his name. Amazing it is. The Word of God makes it enormously clear that the child of God is nature. The very nature of the child of God is Lord. No matter what, I'm going to be grateful. In Hebrews chapter 12, verse 28, New King James says this, therefore, since we are receiving a kingdom which cannot be shaken, you know, you are going to receive a kingdom. We are kingdom people. Let us have grace. Carefully see this, you know, by which we may serve God acceptably with reverence and godly fear. Now, if you have NIV translation of the same passage, Hebrews 12:28, therefore, since we are receiving a kingdom that cannot be shaken, let us be thankful. Carefully see that. New King James says, let us have grace. NIV says, let us be thankful. Is there a difference? Absolutely not. You know, both these versions are correct translations. Because in Greek, to have grace, haris, is to say thank you. you know, thank you. That's all, you know. If you are a recipient of God's grace, which we have been saying in 2 weeks, you know, giving in love under grace, you'll always be thankful. The modern Greek word for thank you is eucharisto, which is directly related to charis, or grace. Thus, there's a direct connection between grace and thankfulness. If you're a child of Jesus Christ, enjoying the grace of Christ, you'll always be a thankful person. So an unthankful person, carefully see this, this is theological truth, a very practical, important truth. So if a Christian, in spite of all receiving the grace of Christ, he is not thankful, he's out of the grace of God, you know. In other words, you cannot be unthankful and be in the grace of God. Deep truth. Very people will understand this, you know. Three Romance languages, languages with the roots in Latin, all retain direct connection between grace and thankfulness. In French, grâce à Dieu means thanks be to God. In Spanish, gracias means thanks and is connected to grace. In Italian, the word thank you is grazie, is directly related to grace. Imagine. It's amazing how grace and thankfulness go together, always. We are children of grace. We are children of gratitude, isn't it? We cannot separate thankfulness from grace of God. And so if we say, let us be thankful, we are also simultaneously telling, let us have grace. You know, we are really saying the same matter of being thankful and being grateful. In Colossians 3:15, and let the peace of God rule in your hearts, to which also we are called in one body, and be thankful. Be thankful is not a suggestion, it's actually a command. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly in all wisdom, teaching and admonishing one another in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing with grace in your hearts to the Lord, and whatever you do in word or deed, do all in the name of the Lord Jesus. What? Giving thanks to God the Father through him. Try this. As a child of a recipient of God's grace, your life will be very different. You know. Is this your distinction as a Christian? So in all that we do, we are instructed to be guided by two spiritual principles. Doing it all in the name of Jesus Christ and giving thanks to God through Jesus Christ. Two very clear things are given to us. Do you do everything in the name of the Lord so that he gets all the glory? Not about your family or your children doing great, please. Be very careful. If we constantly take credit for ourselves, soon we'll be traveling one wandering path. We'll have a difficult time to come back. But if we are training ourselves, Lord, because of you, all this has happened. We give you glory, you know. And then we give thanks to God all the time. Giving thanks then is not an option. It is a command. The word of God says, I'm not making it up. If we go through the word of God, it's a command. Ephesians 5:18-20, when we are full of the Holy Spirit, we will continually give thanks. Have you noticed? In some languages, before people pray, they'll keep on saying, Stotram, Stotram, Stotram. Have you noticed that? They want to begin by thanking God. That's a way to have that spirit. That's an indicator, actually, that you're full with the Holy Spirit, isn't it? You just go and don't go to God with a shopping list of things. That's not prayer. Prayer is always telling Stotram, 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 Stotram. You begin that way, and then you will see your spirit will change. That means you're grateful for many, many answered prayers, and you're approaching the throne of grace, mercy seat. You know, no wonder spiritual child of God is a thankful vessel, and God loves a thankful person. Thankfulness is a great blessing indicator. You know, you teach your children, right? When you give something, you say, what do you say? What's the magic word? Thank you. Thank you. But sometimes I will notice over the years it becomes very less inaudible voice. Say thanks. You know, I used to, you know, Danny Davis and other volunteers who came with me, we used to conduct next year, we are going to conduct this free computer skill training in Kenya. So this tribal people, anyway, of course, they thank you with, you know, very quiet way. I used to insist those students, say thank you, because they just take the food and then walk out. I said, nothing doing. Say thank you to Jesus, you know. I used to insist because I wanted to instill with those young people the sense of gratefulness to God. You know, when we read about all that is happening, I'm sure you're reading, there are millions of children without food and clothing, orphans going through some incredible tough times. Young couples separated from each other in Ukraine, bombed day and night. Look at us in America, what many blessings, innumerable, county of blessings. Cannot, you know. 1 Thessalonians 5, 16, 17, and 18, rejoice always, pray without ceasing, and what? In everything, give thanks. Sometimes we say, oh, I'm waiting, but go ahead and give thanks. Thank you, Lord, for giving me the spirit to be patient, you know. Rejoice always. In everything give thanks, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus for you and I. Isn't it? Rejoice always takes more grace to do it. Pray without ceasing can never come to the end of praying. We'll always keep praying with thanksgiving. In everything give thanks, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus for you. What is the will of God in Christ Jesus for you and I? To give thanks in everything. So if you are not giving thanks, may I say, in the love of Christ, you are actually out of the will of God. Do you get the point? The first point, if you are not giving thanks, you are out of the grace of God. Or you are not having a real experience of the grace of God. Or you are denying the grace of God that has been given to you. And if you are not giving thanks to God, second point, important point, you are out of the will of God. Because those who stay in God's will always be grateful for the blessings. We should never cease to be continually thankful. Never cease to be continually thankful. When we are thankful, we are responding appropriately to God's goodness. Our thanksgiving points to the goodness of God. Our praise points to the greatness of God. And our worship points to the holiness of God. These are three important things that we... The word of God makes it enormously clear, you know. God is good, so I want to thank him. God is great, I want to praise him. God is holy, I want to worship him. Philippians 4:16, be anxious for nothing. That's what I believe, Sam Thini wanted to read. But in everything, by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving. Look at it, with thanksgiving, in everything, in thanksgiving. Let your requests be made known to God. We are instructed never to bring a prayer request to God without thanksgiving. It's a clear instruction from the word of God. Don't ever take as a shopping list and God has answered no. Lord, you have answered so many prayers. You have given me a track record of so much, Lord. I cried out to you and you answered me. How can I ever come and doubt your provision in this situation? Isn't it? He cannot. He cannot. The word of God is saying, whatever request you have for God, bring it to him with thanksgiving. Lord, you are able. You are able. I thank you. Anticipation. I thank you for you are able, Lord. We have seen the exhortations concerning thankfulness. One of the important functions of thankfulness is that it provides access to God. Okay? Now, God never is going to say, have mercy upon me from any place. God will hear you and have mercy on you. But I want to give you another very spiritual, deep, deep spiritual things found in Psalm 100, verse 4. What is it? Enter into his gates with thanksgiving. That means, and into his courts with praise, be thankful to him and bless his name. The gates give us admission to the courts, and the courts give us access to the actual house and presence of God. Imagine, very carefully. It's in sometimes God's word is more than logic. That means this is the way God operates. And he makes it enormously easily clear for us to do it, isn't it? A person who goes to God's presence will always approach with grateful hearts, thankful hearts. You know, there is a room for finding fault, grumbling, murmuring. No. This is the prescribed spiritual route to gain close access to God with thanksgiving and praise. So, there's no room for a grumbling, murmuring, thankless person in God's presence. No, cannot. God gets very upset when people in the wilderness, you remember, they were murmuring. He was very upset, you know. And also remember, rather we have enormous reasons to come into his presence, rejoicing with thanksgiving and praise. Psalm 100 verse 5 says, what's the reason? For the Lord is good. His mercy is everlasting, and his truth endures to all generations. Three important facts, very important. Psalms 100 packs it. No matter what our circumstances, your circumstances, my circumstances, situations may be, no matter how I feel, you feel, you know, people go with feelings. No, God is never going to treat me with how I feel, you know. Jonah was feeling so mad, but God was merciful to Jonah, isn't it? God is not going to stop according to our feelings. He doesn't. No matter how we feel, no matter what may happen or even what happens to us, three cardinal facts never change. What is it? Number one, the Lord is always good. The Lord is good no matter what our situation, challenges, discouragement, how we feel, God is good. Okay? Then second point, his mercy is everlasting. Mercy is everlasting. You know, God is good, mercy is everlasting, and God's truth endures for all generations. Those three are very important. So these everlasting and unchanging reasons are there constantly for us to be thankful to God. Oh God, you're always good. Oh God, I cry out to you. You're merciful. Oh God, your truth keeps me going on the right path. Let us focus on these eternal, unchanging aspects of God's nature and of God's dealings with us on a daily basis. This will help us to thank God ceaselessly. Now, quickly going to Luke chapter 17, verses 11 through 16, you know the instance of how this fellow's 10 lepers cried out, 9 of them Jewish lepers, 1 was a Samaritan. You know, as the saying in English, saying, say, misery seeks company. You don't care about who is a Jew or a Samaritan. All lepers cluttered together and they were crying to Jesus. And Jesus gave them a very short word, go, fellas, go and show yourself to the priest. As they went, they got physically healed. Carefully see this, isn't it? Only one fellow, the unlikely candidate, Samaritan leper who got physically clean, when he saw he was clean, he didn't run to his wife and mommy, daddy, to brothers, sisters, nobody. He ran back where? To the feet of Jesus. He ran back and he didn't care who looked at him. He cried out and fell at his feet and thanked him, glorified God, thanked him, oh, you are the one. You gave me healing. Look at that, captured the spirit of Samaritan. You'll do well in life. I'll do well in life. You see? He ran. And he didn't care about family and all those things. How often we are raising to our own, This man raised towards God. And what happened? So Jesus answered and said, were there not 10 cleansed? But where are the 9? I hope you are not the 9. In other words, God expects you to be very grateful, very thankful, you know. Very, very important fact. To children, learn to be very grateful. Don't be one of the 9, you know. Were there not any found who returned to give glory to God except this foreigner, whom the Jews called dog, Samaritan? And he said to him, arise, go your way. Your faith has made you well. You know, in Greek translation, the faith has to do with salvation, spiritual healing. Those 9 got physical healing. This man got physical and spiritual healing. So if you are grateful, you are going to have lots of spiritual blessing. If you are not grateful, God will bless you physically, materially. That's all. You will not be a spiritual child of Him. No. You know, that's a very vast difference between those whom God has given material blessings and those whom God has given spiritual blessings. You will see that. Their demeanor, their attitude, you know, in their character, in their the way they give priorities in life, their humility. God resisted the proud, you know. The whole thing, you know. Example of the special access to God that heartfelt thankfulness provides. Look at it. He ran with gratitude and God gave him special access. Come, my son, I'll heal you spiritually. Come, my daughter. Yes, faith was exercised by all the 10 lepers. Of course, faith at two levels, physical and spiritual. So although all 10 lepers were cleansed, they ran to the priest and wanted to go home. Never bothered about who gave the healing. Only the one unexpected Samaritan who returned to give thanks to Jesus was saved. Your faith has made you well, whole, holistic. Gratitude makes you whole. According to Greek, your faith has saved you. Go in peace. Go in shalom. Each of them had a physical healing, but only the one who came back to offer thanks received the eternal spiritual healing of salvation. Very serious, isn't it? So, gratitude should be the fundamental thing in our heart. Humility is another one. Love is supreme. You know, it's amazing. Healed from leprosy, physical, and healed spiritually, born of the Spirit, this man. Thanksgiving provides special access to God. Thanksgiving also unlocks the spirit supernatural power of God Almighty. Let's go and see that example. John 6, verses 10 through 12. Those people who are all hungry, thousands of them, they stayed over 3 days listening to Jesus. Didn't go home. Stayed with the family. Just kept on listening to the word of God. Just being near to Jesus. Oh, how often we are oppressed by this clock control culture. We are oppressed. Oh, time to do this, time to. As if God matters nothing, you see, who gives us breath in our nostrils. So these people were walking with Jesus and stayed with him, listening to him 3 days. And Jesus said, they'll faint. So I'm going to, you give them something to eat. Then everybody came with their own reason. Send them away, it's too dark. And then all these Philip and others made financial calculations, said, oh, even if we make all this money, there won't be enough food to go get it. And there is this and that. Jesus knew what he wanted to do and supernatural power. Then Jesus said, make all the people sit down. Now there was much grass in the place. So the men sat down in number about 5,000 supernatural. And Jesus took the loaves and when he had, what is that? Underline that. When he had given thanks. You see, home. Before eating, a place of gratitude. See? Jesus took the bread after a little fellow, 5 loaves and 2 small fish. You know, that little chap was so giving. Isn't it amazing? And he gave thanks and then distributed to the disciples. And the disciples, those sitting down, and likewise of the fish as much as they wanted. So when they were filled, he said to his disciples, gather up all the fragments that remain, so that nothing is lost. Wasting food is not good in the sight of God. So many are suffering, isn't it? Those who deal with the third world, you know what I'm talking. Wasting food, throwing food, it's not good at all. We have to give an account to God, isn't it? Verse 11, and when he had given thanks, the scripture says that our Lord Jesus took the loaves of the little boy, and all he did was thank God. He didn't make a long prayer, did he? No. And what he had in his hand, same thing at the Lord's Supper, which has got deep spiritual meaning. When he had taken the bread, he gave thanks, broke it, and gave to his. When he had taken the cup, gave thanks, and gave to his. Deep lessons today. Deep lessons. for a child of God. For carnal Christian, these are all, oh, come for Thanksgiving, eat and go. No. For deep spiritual people, oh God, thank you, Lord, for teaching. The scripture says that our Lord Jesus took the loaves and then did. Even those from other small boats were there, they also got food. The miracle was released not by some long prayer, but simply by our Lord Jesus giving thanks. Remember, the power of God is released when we learn to give thanks at all times. Remember this lesson. You give thanks, power of God will be released. But if you murmur, gripe, fault-finding, complain, finger-pointing, you are not going to experience power of God. No. You are going to be an alien. John chapter 11, verse 41, 42. Lord Jesus stood before the tomb of Lazarus, who had been buried for 4 days. Dead, dead, stinking, they said. Don't even go near. Again, he did not pray a long prayer. Look what the scripture says. Our Lord Jesus said in verse 41, and Jesus lifted up his eyes. You know, he wept at all those things. Father, I thank you that you have heard me. Look at it. These are models for our children of Jesus to pray and live. I thank you, he said. Isn't it? We need to cultivate the habit of thanking God so that we will experience the power, supernatural power of God and release for his glory. Let's put more thanksgiving in our prayers and petitions so that they are effective. You put more thanksgiving in a petition. Lord, I thank you that you are sufficient for this need of mine, physical need of mine, spiritual need of mine. This child is giving me a lot of problems, challenging me. I thank you, Lord. I prayed for this child. You gave me like Hannah. You'll come out on top, isn't it? Remember, prayer is not simply a question of asking God a shopping list for things which will be very limited and inadequate way of prayer. Like many different instruments in an orchestra, prayer has a couple of elements: thanksgiving, praise, and worship. Make sure your prayer has these three elements: thanksgiving, praise, and worship. Then only you are going to worship. If you don't have thanksgiving, you cannot be in a spirit of worship. Because God, somehow I've noticed, you cannot worship God if you are not thankful, you know. These are all essential parts of prayer. There is no access to God into his presence without thanksgiving and praise. This will result in a fruitful and a successful prayer life. Remember, thanksgiving relates to what? God's goodness. And praise relates to what? God's greatness. How great thou art, we say. And then what? The other one is what? Worship relates to God's holiness. He's holy God. The same order is seen in Psalm 106, verse 47, thanks and praise. 2 Corinthians 2:14, we really cannot separate praise and thanks, and thanks and praise, not possible. They are always going together. So, Hebrews chapter 13, verse 15 through 16 says, therefore, by him let us continually offer what? Sacrifice of praise to God. That is the fruit of our lips, giving thanks to his name, but do not forget to do good and to share, for with such sacrifices, God is well pleased. Sacrifice. We bring the sacrifice of praise. We praise and thank God even if matters go contrary to our expectation, especially contrary to our feelings. You know, life is going to contrary go to our feelings. If you are controlled by feelings, you are immature. God matures my feelings. That's the story of Psalms. You remember? Even King David said, oh, I had enough of seeing this wicked flourish, Lord. Then God made him, urge him to go to the temple. Then when he went to the temple, he figured it out. God deciphered to him the quick end of those godless people. Theological inner deep depth comes in the presence of God, in the house of God. They all help us have proper response to God who is above all our situations so that we are not dictated or controlled by our feelings. I don't know why I preferred this, but I'm telling you, if you are a person, a child of God based on your feelings, you're not maturing. God says, you have to be dictated by my constancy. God is unchanging. His love never changes, isn't it? So does my feeling, I feel down and forsaken, does it mean God has stopped? But he has given the word. In Jeremiah clearly said, I have loved you with an everlasting love. Enough for me. That's good enough. I'm loved. Why do I need to have any more control by my feelings? You know, it's very good. We are asked to thank and praise God continually in everything. In everything, give thanks. Praise and thanksgiving. What? Silences the devil who whispers in your ears. He will leave you. When you keep on telling stotram, stotram, and praise him, praise him, praise him, you know, the devil will say, well, I better find a whining, murmuring, complaining soul and then hug that soul so that it'll cry and, oh, things are all gone wrong. I'm in the valleys and in the dumps. Go and see Silas and Paul were beaten so badly. And what did they do in the prison in Philippian jail? What did they do? They sang songs and praised God. And the presence of God came, bang! And the earthquake took place, and even the jailer all got converted. Carefully see. Don't hear the voice of the pastor. Hear the voice of the Holy Spirit from the Word of God giving examples. Don't make your life all about you, please. Make your life all about Jesus. You'll mature real fast, isn't it? Acts 16:25, Paul and Silas. I've already told you what happened. Anyway. And also 2 Chronicles chapter 20, verse 2, Jehoshaphat. You remember, he was so nervous and frightened a king. But he made people to praise and thank. In front of the army, he put musicians, praise and thanksgiving people. And the Lord defeated the enemy. Look at those people who praise God who came around 7 days, you remember? The walls of Jericho came down, right? Sometimes you will feel walled. Oh, I'm walled. Oh, this America is full of this. Oh, oh, oh. I came from a very different background. Hallelujah, praise God, no matter what. Even if things go bad, you know. Yeah, I'm telling you. I have food to eat, clothes to wear, shelter. Every morning I woke up and say, Lord, have mercy upon me. Thank you for watching over my sleep. You know, remember where you came from, isn't it? We were lost, but now we are found. Let nothing change our relationship to God. You know, Psalm 95, verse 1 and 2, oh, come, let us sing to the Lord. Let us shout joyfully to the rock of our salvation. Hallelujah. Let us come before his presence with thanksgiving, dancing, thanksgiving. Isn't it? Hallelujah. Before the conclusion, we need to look at the dark side of truth and blessing of thankfulness. What is that? The opposite of being thankful. There is a dark side of, especially children, teach them to be thankful. The whole Bible has a great deal to say about unthankful people. In Romans 1:21, because although they knew God, they did not glorify him as God, nor were thankful, but became futile in their thoughts. In other words, thankless people are cursed by God. They become futile. They may do well in life. They'll have all the things. Something or other, they're futile in their thoughts. That means it's not prosperous. Spiritually, they're not doing well. You know, their foolish hearts were darkened. By whom? By some force. By God's curses. That's what the word of God. That's a logical outworking of unthankfulness. Paul outlines the decline of the human race from the inherent knowledge of God to appalling wickedness. Two dark pits. Look at it. Two dark pits. The people do not glorify God as God. Take glory to themselves. Oh, I've done this well. Oh, I am this, I am them. Nebuchadnezzar immediately was reduced to an animal level. Moment you say, is it not the Babylon I built? Instantly. Mene, mene, tekel, uparsin, instant. Isn't it? God alone will be glorified. He will never give his glory to anybody. This church is built on that. He must increase and we must decrease. You know, that's the style of this church. You know, God resisteth the proud, but giveth grace to the humble. Two dark pits. The people did not glorify God as God. Second dark pit, they were not thankful. Stunning. When I was preparing it, stunning. It's a dark pit, dark alley. You know, unthankful people. Every time a person ceases to be thankful, he or she starts down a slippery path. Sadly, many do not make it back because it's a dark and dangerous path. That's why some people are, you know, I deserve to have this. You can rest assured that person is suffering from thanklessness. You know, be very careful. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. I don't deserve, Lord, but you have been kind to me. You know, God will lift you like anything. You know, 2 Timothy chapter 3, verse 1 has got a long list of darkness. And that list has got ungrateful people. This passage contains another fearful list. You read that list, you get nervous, frightened. But it says what is happening today, you know. And verse 2, unthankful and unholy run together, isn't it? Immediately, unthankful, unholy. Read that. A child of God cannot be holy and unthankful. Not possible. Not possible. The word of God says not possible. You can't be a holy set-apart vessel set aside for God's glory and also be thankless running around, you know. A holy set-apart child of God will always remain thankful, always. The conduct that's opposite of being thankful is what? Murmuring, complaining, fault-finding, finger-pointing, you know. Incredible. Some people say, I'm 20 years into this, and look at them. When the litmus test comes, they'll run in the opposite direction. Let us not be that kind of person. Also found in Numbers chapter 21, murmuring poisons the spirit of a child of God. Fiery serpent will bring into their life. Spiritual reality I'm talking about, you know. That will bring also God's judgment. When God leaves you and he distances from you on a daily basis because we practice, thanklessness, there is a distance from God. Being thankful opens our hearts and minds to God's presence and miracle working power. These are important truths. Let us be thankful as we have reasons for being thankful. Let us decide to practice thanksgiving to God at all times. No matter what happens, let us keep on thanking God and say, Lord, I thank you no matter what happens. There's a story told of this Baptist preacher, Dr. George Stewart. He got an accepted invitation to preach in a church because they needed a new sanctuary building. He arrived at the church about 10 minutes early, and before the service started, the deacons called him up and said, Pastor, we need to raise $6,500 by the next day in order to finish paying for the building. The church officers told him that they were depending upon his message to raise his money. I was the wrong person to talk to. So Pastor Truett preached the sermon, then said, these men bid me, in the sermon he exposed them, these men call me to tell you that you must give $6,500, which is all due tomorrow. Will you provide for us? After Dr. Truett's appeal began the slowest, most reluctant, most Christ-shaming offering he had ever witnessed. You know, you can't amp these people. Yeah, bring it now. You know, you cannot. You know. You can't pry open a tight fist. You can't pull the feathers. You know, not possible, especially from a peacock. You can't. It will not let you get a feather out. Really very difficult. Impossible. Anyway, only $3,000, not even half of what they needed. So Dr. Truett looked at them, the leaders, and said, what do you expect of me? I'm your guest. I do not happen to have another $3,500. He said, I'm not going to give you that. I'm just a guest. A little woman quietly rose and addressed her husband in the church who was at the front of the church recording what was given. With pathos in her voice, she said, "Charlie, I wondered if you would be willing for us to give our little cottage just paid for so that we are debt-free now. We were offered $3,500 in cash for it yesterday by somebody. We were told we could get it at the bank anytime in 10 days if we choose to make the trade. $3,500? Give me your heart." The lady said, "Charlie, I have wondered if you would be willing for us to give our little house to Christ, that his house may be free of debt. When we remember, Charlie, that Christ gave his life for us, I wonder if we ought not to give this little house to him." We need wives like that, right? Or vice versa, we need husbands like that. I don't know who is holding the purse, but I think this is a good illustration. God knows. Charlie responded in the same spirit, "Jenny, dear, there you go. I was thinking of the same thing. We will give $3,500. Then silence fell upon the whole church. And then grown men began sobbing, and almost in a moment that $3,500 was given by men and women who for the last half hour had either refused to give or had given grudgingly. Remember, we had a series, isn't it? Many visitors had come for that special service. And before an invitation was given, men and women came down the aisle in the church wanting to be saved. The gratefulness of that one couple for what the Lord had done for them and the desire to give him prompted others to give, and many get to be saved. Gratitude demonstrated will lead to the salvation of people, isn't it? Waldo Emerson, you know, Ralph Waldo Emerson, said, "If stars come once in a blue moon, all of us will run to see the stars. Because they are there every night in the sky, nobody bothers to even look at the moon, isn't it? It's amazing, because we get making things for granted, you know. We get accustomed to everything, you know. And the Israelites in the wilderness got accustomed to their blessings. Yucky, only the manna every day, they said. You remember that thing, you know. Remember Numbers chapter 11. Now our whole being is dried up, you know. There's nothing at all except this manna before our eyes. Hey, children, hear this. Mommy, every day this one." Just say, let us read Numbers chapter 11. Stop everything, isn't it? Is that right, children? Huh? Yesterday, Betty was asking, "Mommy, ghee is not enough. Give me more ghee." I said, "Stir it up nicely, Kamala." She said, "No, I don't smell it." Because she was finishing off the ghee that was given quickly and not mixing up with the rice, isn't it? Interesting how children are smart ones, you know. It's amazing how we can cherish the spirit of gratitude. A gardener had been working very diligently, particular rose, which was very beautiful to look at it. So when he went out one morning to his favorite rose bush, he found that flower of which he had taken such care was gone. He was very upset, for he thought that some bad boy had stolen into the garden. It could be a bad girl also, please don't take offense, you know. Anyway, and has taken away the best flower. He was complaining very bitterly of his loss when someone said, "The master has been down in the garden this morning and he has been admiring this rose bush. And he has taken away that fine bud of which you were so proud." Then the gardener was so delighted that he had been able to grow a flower that had attracted his master's notice. Instead of mourning any longer, he began to rejoice. So should it be with anything on which we have set our hearts? Let us Let each one of us say to our Master, my Lord, if it pleases you, take it. If it pleases me to lose it, let it be sold. Why should I complain because you have taken from me what is really you want, you know? And so there was a man who told his dear buddy, hey, I want you to go with me during this winter blast. I want you to hear the most thankful preacher I've ever heard. So the two men gathered and went to weather the weather storm, terrible storm, to hear him preach in the winter. On the way, they thought nobody would be there in the church, that even the preacher wouldn't be come. But when they got to the little country church, there was a preacher seated on the platform ready, you know. The stranger said to his friend, hey, he has nobody to preach to. There's a storm outside. It looks like we'll have a flood. He won't have anything to be thankful for tonight. Yes, he will. He will thank God for something. His friend who brought him said that. When the preacher stood up, he bowed his head and prayed, dear Lord, it is stormy outside. It looks as if the roads will wash away before we can get out of the church tonight. It's an awful storm, but we are thankful that it's not always this way. Amazing, isn't it? Romans 8:28. In everything, give thanks. In all, for all things work together for good to them who love God. Now, here is the mother. She says, Alice Johnson is her name. When I was a young mother with the two preschoolers, I was often overwhelmed. One night I fell into the bed exhausted. I poured out my frustrations to God. She said, she quotes and says it, the kids won't mind. The house is a mess. My husband doesn't seem to care. The list went on and she put her head to the pillow. Suddenly a small voice came to her heart. Which one do you want me to take away? Everything I was complaining about was precious to me. Immediately I began to thank God for everything on my list, something I continue to do now as a grandmother. Yeah? Which one? You want me to take away your children? You want me to take away your husband? You want me to take away the house? Which one you wanted? She sobered up and said, wait a minute. I think I better thank God for all. It's amazing how people, you know. I want to tell you something about a preacher in Mozambique. In 2000, February, Mozambique experienced its largest rainfall in more than 50 years. Some of you may have seen Y2K year, you know. By March 2nd, there were an estimated 1,000 Mozambicans, people who needed to be evacuated, around 7,000 people who were trapped in the trees. They ran up the trees. You probably would have seen that news, you know. One Mozambique minister named Samuel Naftal gave thanks to God, and he also thanked God for mosquitoes, for saving his life. Wait a minute, what is mosquitoes got to do with this fellow? As Samuel, along with 16 other people, he clung tightly to the limbs of the trees for 2 days, he began to preach. All of them hoped his preaching would keep them alert to their surroundings. They drop down, they'll be drowned, no help. So here is a quote. Samuel prayed, I help people climb onto the roof of my house and climbed into a tree with others and said, Pastor Samuel, we saw televisions, furniture, and dead calves floating past. Everything was destroyed. The people asked me to preach to them so that they would stay awake. Today I thank God for the mosquitoes because they prevented me from falling asleep. And falling into the water, I would have been simply swept away. So he had to keep on hitting the mosquitoes that kept him going. You know, amazing, isn't it? What all God can do through various, count your blessings, name them one by one. It's amazing. Now, finally, I want to give you an illustration. For some of you who are grumbling about your house, I want to give you this illustration. I heard a fellow wanted to dispose of his home. He's had enough of living in that home. He called his real estate agent and said, I want to run an ad in the paper to sell my home. Get rid of it as quickly as you can. I'm tired of this old castle of mine. The agent said, oh, go ahead, tell me something about your home so I can run a good ad. The man told him how many rooms it had. It had carpet. There were expensive shrubs in the yard. He told about some fruit trees in the backyard and many other advantages. He described the house in detail. Well, I can tell. I got a mailbox in front of my house when I want to sell. A lot of new homes don't get it. I got a mailbox. Thank God for mailbox, isn't it? You don't have to go to a common place. Please don't misunderstand. When he finished, the agent said, well, I'll read it back to you and you tell me how it sounds. He read the ad about this beautiful three-bedroom home with the two baths, a good stand of grass, fruit trees in the backyard, new roof, central air conditioning, a remodeled carport for two cars. He kept on reading until the owner says, stop it right there. Wait a minute, stop. That house is not for sale. All my life, I've been wanting a place like that, but I didn't realize I had one until now. Isn't it amazing? So don't complain about the house God has given to you. May the Lord God bless. As we continue to thank God, may God abundantly bless you to have a blessed Thanksgiving. Remember, now, therefore, O God, we thank you and praise your glorious name. O give thanks to the Lord, for he is good and his steadfast love endures. When upon life's billows you are tempest tossed, when you are discouraged and all is lost, count your many blessings one by one, and it praise you what the Lord has done. Count your blessings one by one. Count your blessings, see what God has done. Count your blessings. Wait a minute. Let's finish it and it will surprise you what the Lord has done. That's the Indian version, okay? All right. All you have a burden with a load of care, does the crossing call to bear? Every doubt will fly and you will be singing as the days go. Blessings, see what God has done. Count your blessings, name them one by one, and it will surprise you what the Lord has done. When you look at others with their lands and gold, your many blessings man cannot buy, your reward in heaven, not home on high. Count your blessings, name them one by one. Count your blessings, God has done. Hallelujah. Count your blessings, name them one by one, and it So amid the conflict, faith is strong. Do not be discouraged, God is over on. Count your many blessings, angel. Your reward in is in. Count your blessings one by one. God has done. Count your blessings, name them one by one, and it will surprise you. The Lord has done. Praise God from whom all blessings flow. Praise. Let's go to the throne of grace. Glorious Father, we thank you with all our heart for who you are, what you are, Lord, to us personally, in our family, in so many ways. You walk with us always. You love us always. Your grace and mercy has never departed us. Lord, your peace, your joy, your hope, your faith from the word of God has undergirded us all these days. Lord, we thank thee from the bottom of our hearts for keeping our names in the book of life. Lord, we thank thee for this sanctuary building you gave to us. When everybody was closing down, you opened a place for us. Historical miracle. Lord, amazing way you have given to us. Thank you for these loved ones who love you and then made tremendous sacrifice to make it all possible. Lord, we thank thee for giving us world vision, not just here only, but going outside, helping needy people. Continue to anoint and bless us as we live in gratitude at your feet. Accept the tithes and offerings. We can never outgive you, Lord. And we pray, Lord, your blessings will descend upon each and every one of us. We pray for your presence throughout this week. And also as we meet together back on Sunday, let your presence continue to be with us. We give thee all the glory, honor, and praise. In Jesus' precious name we pray. Amen. May the grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the love of our eternal Heavenly Father, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit rest and abide with us both now and forever. Amen. God bless you. Have a very blessed and happy, joyful Thanksgiving Day. Thank you. God bless you.